Right on the concert piano. Lies in his bed. Tough. Why did you say I'm playing as I used to?
Martin, you haven't. I didn't mean anything by that remark, except that you appear better.
My music sounds better.
I never lied. Yes.
He has come here for 2 nights.
What do you mean? Why don't you go on?
You hear that, Helen? That's the way Greece meant his music to be played. And listen to this. It speaks of the strange terror and mystery of life.
That's not why I couldn't play it.
He must.
second-hand demon.
Helen, there's something I must tell you. I must tell someone, or I go mad. Perhaps I am.
Said the culprit didn't go.
In one of the worst performances of my entire career. It was late that same night. The first note.
Note?
The friend of another being. Close.
Another being?
Yes, an invisible being. It was he who made the place the best. I know it sounds strange, fantastic. It's real, Helen. This thing seeks to dominate, to possess. It came first in my sleep. Lately, I've begun to feel its presence, even in my waking hours. It controls my actions like a hypnotist controls his object.
Go on.
It doesn't speak to me directly. It merely repeats my words. Make his will felt. And I fight to resist, and I can't. Yes, I'm afraid it will. And I'll... What? That's right. It's near us now.
Here?
Yes, can't you feel its breath?
Look there, look.
It's a curtain, too. He's in here, Helen. In here.
Not in the window.
No. The invisible being. He came in through the window.
Look. That thing is gone. That's nothing but the wind.
No, it's him, Helen.
Wait a minute. What's the matter?
No. Take protection.
No. Why don't you answer me? Why are you holding out your hands as though? No, Martin, don't touch me. For heaven's sake, don't. You're not yourself, Martin. Martin, wake up. Wake up! Martin, listen to you. This is the deep way to use it. You must come out. The power is away from my throat. Martin!
Don't draw away from me, Helen. I won't come. Helen, come back. Come back, Helen. Even that invisible being urged me to fear. But oh, is there such a thing? Or am I blind? Could it be? Yes, I will make the test tonight. Why do you echo my words? Why do you torment me? Why don't you ever let me sleep? Or am I sleeping now? Am I dreaming? Stop, I must open my eyes. I must.
Not a single drop on the table or on the floor. The glass was empty when it fell.
Our inner sanctum mystery will continue in just a moment.
Friends, let's return to tonight's inner sanctum mystery. Let's see, where were we?
Oh, yes.
Martin Corelli, obsessed with the thought that an invisible being is torturing him, makes an experiment and discovers evidence to strengthen his strange belief. We find him in his room, wandering over the evidence he has just set on.
No doubt about it now. I must find a way to destroy this thing. I must kill it before... Here. Oh, you came back again. I never heard your voice before while I was awake. Who are you?
You.
Tell me your name. What is your name?
Horla.
Horla. Oh, you do understand what I speak to. Why have you never spoken to me before?
I did not choose to.
What do you want with me?
I thought you knew.
Oh, I imagined all sorts of things, but I never knew. What do you want with me?
I will come to you when you sleep. When you are helpless. After each minute, you will be more and more under my power. Until finally you will become my complete slave. Do it as I will.
Your slave?
Yes.
Where are you now?
Sitting here, in the chair near your bed, waiting for you to go to sleep again.
I will not go.
You must sometimes. That is the great weakness of your race of humans.
Remain awake until you leave. I'll never go to sleep again as long as I live.
We shall see. I have great patience. What are you doing?
Going to light a cigarette.
Put that match down.
Oh. What?
Put it down, I tell you.
No. I lit it.
Put it out.
Oh. Oh, you can feel me. You are afraid of the flame.
Stand back. Don't come near me.
I have found your weakness now. You fear flame, fire. Now we shall see who is in trouble.
Don't come near me.
Cut. I put a match to them and they go up in flames. There. See the fire. You cannot get through the window now. And the door is locked. I have you trapped. You hear? Trapped.
You cannot destroy me.
Then why are you afraid? Why?
Let me out of here.
No. See, I like it. Now I have a sword, a weapon against you who have so much power. But fear the flame.
Don't touch those sheets.
You, somewhere in this room. You whom I cannot see. You who attack men in their sleep. Command them to do your horrible business. You are the living spirit of evil. You seek to have men destroy each other so that you can conquer the earth.
Let me out of here.
Oh, how many men have pleaded for mercy from you? Do you think I will show you the slightest mercy now? You shall be destroyed here. No. You will not escape through this door. I will back out holding my blazing newspaper before you. You're right. Old clothes, soap in the skeleton, drop them in front of the door, put a match to them. Helen, open the door. Open the door, the house is on fire.
What?
Hurry, will you? The house is filling with smoke and flames. I'm spreading rapidly.
Yes.
Are the servants
on? They're on the other side of the house. They're all asleep.
Where did they come from?
In my room.
Mm-hmm.
You? Mm-hmm. My
husband.
Yes. He was in there. The invisible being. The Horla.
What? Oh, no.
Helen, try to understand. Helen, come back here. Help me.
We are by the way. The flame is dead, madly about the house. By this time, the flame is burning. Tongues of fire. Red, yellow, orange, blue.
Flame leaping high in the air. Light the dark night like a huge, magnificent torch.
That shot in the roof is crumbling between the walls. A pound of flame roars out of the ground. Suddenly the whole shot begins to stop. In a moment it comes crash to the ground. Funeral fire, a monstrous, magnificent funeral fire. And in it, he who hates and fears the flame is burning. He, my prisoner. Invisible being, the Horla.
I want you to give me.
Step up.
That's the only way.
You told the patient that you know what will happen. I friend.
Darling, you will be. You will be medical attention.
Medical attention? Then you believe me. You think I'm insane, don't you? Don't you?
Where'd you come to?
Yes, there was a time when I thought I was. But now I am certain I am not. It's a week, a full 7 days since our house burned down. And I haven't felt the Horla nearly once. I tell you, he was real, Helen. This invisible being was as real as you or I.
Perhaps. But if that's the case, then you have nothing to fear. The doctors will examine you and find you normal.
Oh, Martin,
don't you see? You have everything to gain by surrendering.
Right. What difference does it make? The only thing that really matters is that the whole life is dead.
Yes.
Do you feel...
What is it now?
Never mind. I'll do as you ask. I'll give myself up. Could you go down to the lobby and wait for me? I'll only be a moment.
All right.
Is it you? And you are not dead?
No.
It was all in vain.
All in vain. You cannot destroy me. Why do you hesitate? Why don't you go down and join her? Give yourself up.
That's what you want me to do, isn't it?
That's the only thing you can do.
No. What is it? There is one other alternative. I made up my mind about what I do if you live through that fire.
You are going to destroy yourself.
Yes. I will not be what you are trying to make. I will not be your slave. I'd rather die.
Martin, put that gun away.
Don't try to stop me.
Kill him. Kill him. Oh, my God.
I had to.